Namobita Majumdar is the founder of Namobita.com, where she develops meaningful messages to the society using different forms of media. Hello, Namobita. It's a pleasure to have you here with us.
Thank you. Thank you so much for inviting me.
Okay, so the first question is, in today's society where youths are mostly dependent on others' decision rather than their own decision, so what would you like to convey to them so that they can trust their instincts and can, make their own decisions?
First and foremost, whether you're young or old, your instincts and your gut feeling is never wrong. Listen to it. If you're not listening to it, you are making a mistake. Yes, the risks may be big. You may need a lot of financial support. Don't worry, take small steps. Make steps that will not, even if it fails, it doesn't affect you much, right? Ek baal se pahar khicho, gaya to baal, aaya to pahar. That's exactly what you have to do. Listen to your instinct. I listened to my instinct years back, right? And the idea that came to me was suddenly a question. It was not even a business proposal. I did not have an Excel sheet. It was just a question in my mind. And my faculty, Dr. Madhukar Shukla, just lit it up all the more. And that's exactly how I moved on. And I did not even realize when it became such a big thing. And there were so many people who were coming along. Take my words. If you're working on your instinct, you have passion in it. People will follow you. If you're doing something right, you're on the right track. You may not have too many people giving you acknowledgement, too many people giving you appreciation, but even if it doesn't happen, if you're solving a problem, you're on the right track. Go on, go forth.
That was amazing, ma'am. So moving on to the next question. Women's education in technology and management is rapidly increasing. So how do you plan to take it further and spread it?
Education, technology. Nothing has changed our life more than these two, right? Think about all these ideas that all these women entrepreneurs and women builders and women organization owners had even 20 years back, but they did not have the technology. They probably had not received the education that you have. Right now, if you are receiving it in 5 years, 10 years from now, you will stand in a world that you have changed. For me, I completely credit my success to education, because the idea that changed my life came from XLRI, the last term, right? I salute all the people who feels that education is not really that important, it's the experience that counts, very true. But there is no currency better than education that will bail you through to your tough times. Technology, do not be scared of it. Whether you are media, whether into media, even if you're a writer, even if you're into creative, get cracking. Learn coding, understand AI. You don't need to code well, you don't need to build a product, but make sure you understand it well. You never know what your ideas will require from those kind of products and will actually make the product lot more accessible to the world that you're building for. You're not here for today. You're here for the next 10 years, next 20 years, next 30 years. In those many years, it's the technology that will go in leaps and bounds. So what you're building today, what you are trying to do today, until and unless you have the support, it will not reach the masses that you need to. Thank you.
Thank you so much, ma'am, for your valuable words.
Thank you. I wish your team a great success.
Thank you so much.
You already made a great success given the kind of numbers that you all have created in the last 2 months. I will look forward to your channel, and I'm sure you all will reach great heights. And kudos to this team for this great work. God bless.
Thank you so much, ma'am.